best car, SUV, or truck, guess what? You're in luck. Frontier Motors is down the street. Got the best deals that can't be beat. Don't overpay, come in today. Doing business the old-fashioned way. Frontier, we've got the right price. Frontier, we'll treat you mighty nice. Frontier Motors, low overhead country.
Hello and welcome to the Frontier Motor Show. My name is Ivan Streckel and we're coming live to you from the Co-Works Annex in beautiful downtown Pensacola right on Palafox Street. For the next half hour, we're going to be talking cars, a little bit what's going on at Frontier Motors, also what's going on in the auto industry, and some auto news, and what Frontier Motors offers to the Pensacola community for the last 22, going on 23 years. So let's start off with the news. For the first quarter, new car sales are awful. I just read this the other day and I didn't believe it, because used car sales are always up when new car sales are down. And for the first quarter, the analysts say that the drop is for no reason. They can't figure out why, other than that the tax returns that are coming back to people are about half of what the prediction was, and therefore people don't have the money for the down payment. Even the most optimistic forecasts for the U.S. auto industry sales in March concede that the industry had its worst first quarter since 2015. So, bad for new car sales, good for used car sales. And by the way, at Frontier Motors, we specialize in the alternative to new. We've been doing that for 22 years. What that means is that the brunt of our inventory are vehicles that are like brand new. As a matter of fact, some of the cars we have on the lot even have as little miles on them as 70 or 100 or 200 miles. But because we are an independent used car dealership, even those cars that are not titled have to be sold as used cars through our dealership. And the only thing that you lose is the fact that if the warranty clock is ticking on those cars, so if it has a four-year warranty, for example, if the car is 2 months old, you'd have a 4 years less 2 months. But the amount of money that you can save on those cars are phenomenal. Getting off track a little bit, the other thing I wanted to announce is that everybody's been waiting for the Jeep Gladiator. Well, it says right now that the production of Gladiator started this month, and they will be starting to deliver in mid-May. The base price is a little bit higher than they originally thought, and the base price is going to be starting out at $37,000, which is quite a bit higher than the Colorado and the Tacoma, which are the segment leaders right now, that are starting about in the mid-20s. So quite a bit more for the Jeep. For the Jeep Gladiator. The top of the line Rubicon, which is going to come out a couple of months after that, is going to start at $47,000, about $10,000 more for the Rubicon. That is, by the way, going to upgrade to an 8-speed transmission. And the Jeep says the priciest Gladiators, fully loaded, are going to top out at $60,000. Now, one of the things they're talking about is that the Gladiator is, of course, like the Wrangler, which is going to have the off-road suspension, the off-road frame. And if you're going to upgrade that with the Colorado or the Tacoma, it also costs quite a bit more to upgrade to that better suspension, which is standard on the Gladiator. So kudos off to the Gladiator. I'm not sure if anybody knows that they're coming out, but Jeep finally has a pickup truck again. Very, very excited about it because we love the Wrangler. It's a very fun vehicle. And the nice thing about the Gladiator is it's going to have a completely removable roof and removable doors. Isn't that kind of cool? And you've got the pickup truck bed in the back. So that's the news for today. We want to talk a little bit about the biggest thing that I've come to talk about is, why would you buy a six-month-old or a one-year-old car versus a brand new one? And I guess the Consumers Report said it best in April's edition. For the first time since I've been doing the show, they actually put the pricing on that depreciation. We all know that the first year when you drive a car off, everybody knows that it loses a ton of money. But nobody really knew, what's a ton of money? Is it $2,000 or is it $10,000? Well, in April's edition, the Consumers Report said that the average price of a new car last year was about $35,000. The first year depreciation was $9,200, which equates to 27%. Isn't that phenomenal? I thought it was more like around $4,000 or $5,000. But they're saying, no, the average appreciation in 1 year is $9,200. Now, that doesn't mean you can come to Frontier Motors and save $9,200, because I've got to make some money on that vehicle that I'm buying at that depreciated rate. On the average, again, some vehicles are less, and some high-line luxury cars are quite a bit more as far as a dollar amount. Obviously, a $100,000 car at a 27% depreciation, that's $27,000 you're losing. A little Toyota Tacoma or Toyota Corolla is not going to lose that much. But $9,200 on the average. In the second year, it goes to 37% and you lose a total of $12,600. If you kept that car for 4 years, you lose on that $35,000 car, you lose $19,000 on that car. Why are people, no wonder the new car industry is down. Why would anybody buy a new car if they know if they changed their mind and decide to sell that car within 1, 2, or 3, or 4 years, they're gonna lose their butt on that car. Why not buy that car 1 year old and save between $4,000 and $5,000 in real money? And don't forget, when you pay $5,000 less for a car, you also save 7.5% taxes on that $5,000. And being a small independent dealer, the fees that we charge are about a third of some of the franchise dealers. We had a sales contract that a customer shared with us that he was at a local dealer on Pensacola Boulevard, and their fees after the this has nothing to do with taxes. Their fees alone to sell the car were almost $1,200. That was their dock fee, their electronic title fee. They had a couple of other get ready and wash up fees in there. These were fees that I'm sure were not discussed when you buy a car. You know, if somebody tells you, I'll sell you that car for $20,000, in the back of your mind, you know that, well, taxes are going to be, you know, about $1,400. And so I should have to come in there with about, you know, $21,400. Well, that's not the case because there are the fees. So one of the things, I never get mad at a dealership if they charge high fees. What I get mad at is when they don't tell the customer, because it gives the used car representatives and dealerships out there a bad spiel. You know, we've got enough bad press the way it is. And I think what dealers should do is they should do the same thing that Frontier Motors does, and that is give you an out-the-door price in writing. When you come on the lot at Frontier Motors, what we're going to do is show you the car, and then we're going to let you test drive the car, and then we're going to give you a price. This doesn't have to be a question like, well, what do you want to pay? You know, how much of a discount do you want? You know, what do you want your payments to be? What we're going to do is do a proposal to you. And I think as us being the selling dealership, we should be telling you how much it's going to cost, and we should be proud enough of our price to put it in writing and give you a copy of it so you can go shopping if you want. Now, a lot of dealerships that have bought from us, a lot of customers that have bought from us, know that they can trust us, that they know that we're going to make money when we sell a car, but that we're never going to rip them off. And that's all people want. They don't want to pay too much. They know you have to make a profit like any business to stay in business. You're going to need to make a profit, but it doesn't need to be obnoxious. So what we do is we price our cars accordingly, according to the condition of the car, according to the mileage and the equipment and the color of the car. Every once in a while, a customer will come and say, well, hey, Ivan, I saw that car down the road for $1,000 less. I said, okay, tell me where it was. So I pull up that car. I do a Carfax report. A lot of times what happens is the car has been in a major accident. That doesn't necessarily make it a bad car, but wouldn't you want to know that? And would you want to be able to buy that car for less money if it was in a major accident, even if it was fixed correctly? The other thing is, what about the equipment on the car? We have the ability to run a window sticker on a car that gives us the actual equipment on that vehicle. And a lot of times you look at a car and you can tell if it's got a sunroof or if it's got leather interior, but you can't tell some of the little things, if it's got air suspension, if it's got automatic or electronic steering, if it's got upgraded wheels, if it has a full-size spare tire, if it has the safety equipment like the automatic braking system, pedestrian detection, blind spot. These are all things that will make a difference when you're comparing one car to another. And a lot of times, even though you think you're comparing apples to apples, maybe the same year and the same mileage, but there could be a difference of $5,000 or $6,000 in equipment in our car. So at $1,000 more, our car becomes a bargain. So we share all this information with you to make sure that you are satisfied when you're making that decision to purchase the car. And one of the things that we are really proud of at Frontier Motors is none of our salespeople pressure you into making a deal. And that's not what you get at some competitors where they do, well, what if I do this? Will you buy it today? It's always that, will you buy it today? Will you buy it today? We want you to buy when you're comfortable buying. You're going to make that decision when you feel that if you are sitting at Frontier Motors, that that is the best car at the best price for you. And we can share you with you what the competitors are selling their car for. We've got a program called Price Driver that tells me every car available within a certain radius. I can default to 150 miles. I can even go nationwide, which we had to do the other day when somebody brought us a Rolls Royce. I didn't know what a Rolls Royce was going to be selling for, so I did a nationwide search and I found out that there were 14 of these 2016 Rolls Royce available. I could see exactly what the market was on that car and I could educate that customer on what a good deal would be for the car. He was trying to have us consign the car, which, by the way, we have on consignment, and I believe we have the least expensive Rolls Royce available with, I think, 3,000 miles on it in the whole nation. These are some of the things that we do at Frontier Motors. Now, there's a lot of other things that we do that I want to touch on, and some of the things have nothing to do with selling cars. They do have to do with the car, with the car buying experience, and they also have to do with helping you when you're ready to sell your car. For example, if you're going to sell your car on Craigslist or eBay or put it on AutoTrader or Cars.com, it would be helpful if you had a history report. And everybody knows what Carfax is. It's the number one provider of history reports in the nation. So we can run that Carfax report, which, by the way, costs about $45. I think it's $39.95 plus tax. We can run it at no charge. I pay one fee and I can run them. I advertise that I run them for our customers. I don't want to do it for other dealerships, but I'd be happy to do it for you. A lot of dealerships that do not provide free Carfax reports. If you find a dealer that you like and you're going to buy that car, call Frontier Motors with the ID number. Let me run that report for you, and I'll tell you what it says, or I'll send you a copy of it. Wouldn't it be nice to know if the car was in a major accident, or maybe if the car was from Pennsylvania or New York or Alaska, and the car is 5 years old? That might have you look at the rust situation on that car a little bit more than if it was an Arizona or a Florida car. Wouldn't you want to know if it had five owners or one owner? Or maybe wouldn't you want to know if it had a bad mechanical history? I had this the other day, and I'm not going to mention the type of vehicle it was because we sell a lot of these cars, but this particular car had five batteries put in the vehicle within a 2-year time frame. Now, we know you can't buy five bad batteries. This car obviously had some type of a drain that the dealership, which, by the way, the vehicle was under factory warranty, the batteries were all put in under factory warranty, but this vehicle had a drain, they couldn't fix it. So you might want to know about that if you were in the process of buying that car, especially if it's from a private individual. And the other neat thing we can do for you when you call us with the ID number to run that free Carfax report is we can tell you what the average selling price of that vehicle is in our area. And a lot of times with having between 350 and 400 cars in stock at all times, we might have very close to the twin to that car in stock. So we can say, hey, by the way, I got that car. I can sell that car for $19,700. What are they asking over there? Oh, they're asking $21,700. Well, then why not? And if you like that dealer and you like the salesman, why not use that information to get them to drop that price to what I'm telling you, I can sell you mine. Obviously, I'm hoping they won't. So you stop in at Frontier Motors and buy our cars. And that's how this whole thing about helping people in the community works. If we help you buy somewhere else, we know that's not the only car you're ever going to buy. And we also are smart enough to know that you probably have friends. And when those friends ask you, where should I buy a car? Most of the time we get recommended because we're the ones that helped you buy that car. Let's say your neighbor has a car for sale. We'll tell you if it's a good deal. We'll give you the history report. And if you've got a vehicle you have to dispose of, maybe you want to buy your neighbor's car and help them out, we'll buy your car from you. That way you're not stuck with two cars. That leads me into another segment about the fact that because we sell between 50 and 60 cars a week, not a month, a week, we need to buy 50 to 60 cars a week. We would love to buy your car. And I know that other dealerships advertise, we'll buy your car, whether you buy a car or kind of. But what happens a lot of times, folks, when you go to those dealerships, is that the buyer is not at the dealership. It gets very frustrating when you go from dealer to dealer trying to sell your car, for example. At Frontier Motors, we always have three buyers. We have four buyers total, but we have three buyers at the dealership all the time. That way, we should be able to give you a buy bid for your car within 15 minutes. The only time it might take longer, if it's an older car, that we would have to get a mechanical inspection first. But if it's a newer car, especially one with low miles on it, we can do the inspection ourselves within a matter of minutes. And the cool thing about these new apps that you have on your iPhones and Apple is that we just scan the, you know, I don't know if you know this, but just like at a grocery store, they have barcodes. Every car has a barcode. If you open your door, there's going to be a barcode on the inside of your door. So what we do is we scan that barcode, and within seconds, all the information comes up on that car. I just plug in the mileage of the car. I normally take a couple of pictures so I can remember what the car looks like, and it immediately defaults to the NADA book, the Black Wholesale Guidebook, the market value at the auctions. It gives you the Carfax report and the auto check report, and it gives me an average selling price. So I can normally do an appraisal very, very fast. And if you have the title in your back pocket, I can just write you a check. If you owe money on that car, what I'll do is I'll pay that car off for you. Once I get the title, you get the remainder of the money if you have positive equity. And a lot of these titles these days are electronic titles, which means that I can actually apply for the title. So you would get your money right away, even though you don't have the title, if it happens to be an electronic title. What's this world coming to when everything is electronic? I remember the old days, if you didn't have a paper title, or if you lost it, we would send you down to the motor vehicle department and get a new one, because we could do nothing if you didn't bring the title in. And it's happened in the old days. I remember paying for a car and not getting the title. Well, you know what, folks? You can't sell a car unless you have the title. So be aware of that. Let's move on a little bit. The other thing I want to let you know also is, I think that when I moved to Pensacola about 24 years ago from Wisconsin, I found out that Pensacola is a red light running capital of the world. Everybody here runs red lights. I don't know what the deal is with it. They don't know the difference between yellow and red and green. But the reason I mention this is because there are a lot of accidents on Pensacola streets. Most of them are broadsides from someone running a red light. So if you got broadsided and it's not your fault, your car has been severely damaged but not totaled, what does that do to the value of the car after it's been fixed? If I run a Carfax on your car and you've got a $30,000 car that's had a major accident, airbags deployed, vehicle had to be towed off the scene, the value of your car is now diminished. We do letters of diminished value for not just our customers, anybody in Pensacola, to help you get more money from the insurance company, the other person's insurance company that was at fault. Because if you trade your car and I'm going to nick it for a bad, what I consider maybe not a bad Carfax report because it's not a total car, but a severely depreciated car because of the accident. Those cars are sellable, but they have to be sellable at a reduced price. I had one the other day that I did, and this car was severely, it was an expensive car. I figured it had $6,000 of diminished value. In other words, for me to put it on the lot and explain what happened, even though it was fixed by a franchise dealer and they gave a warranty with the fix-its, that car should be sold between $6,000 and $8,000 less. So I gave them a letter so they could get reimbursed from the insurance company. Because if it's not your fault, it's not right, is it? That now your car, let's say you bought a brand new Cadillac and it was a $60,000 car and somebody broadsides you. Well, that car now has got a terrible hit for the resale value of that car. So we'll help you get some money from the insurance company. The other thing we'll help you with, what if you get broadsided and now your car gets totaled? Well, make sure that you don't just take the first offer you get from the insurance company, even though it might be a good offer. Call us at Frontier Motors. Let us do a book out for you. Let us do some comparables for you so you have some ammunition that if we tell you you should get $20,000 for your car and the insurance company says $17,000, you've got some ammunition to go back to them and say, wait a minute, I was at Frontier Motors and they already told me to replace this car. I should be getting $20,000. And don't forget, folks, if the car is worth $20,000, they should also reimburse you the taxes. Because if you walk into a dealership and buy that car for $20,000, you've got to pay about 7 or 7.5% tax on top of that. You've got to pay a dock fee on top of that. And you've got to pay the tag transfer, a title fee. All those fees should be reimbursed by the insurance company. So again, a little thing that we would help you with. And I believe that we're the only dealer that I know of in Pensacola that does this in writing. A lot of dealers will tell you, oh yeah, your car's dropped $2,000 in value, but they won't sign anything because they're always afraid they're gonna have to go to court. I'm not afraid of that. We know what we're doing. We've been doing appraisals like this for 22 years. So I think in 22 years, we've had 2 court appearances. So to me, it's worth it to help people in the community out to make sure that they get their just due if it's an accident that they didn't cause. So again, I was getting off track a little bit by talking about we would like to buy your car. Get the word out that if you're going to, why put it on Craigslist? Have you, the first 5 paragraphs on Craigslist is about scams. Don't do this, don't do this, don't go for a test drive, don't give the customer your car. Be careful about the money. Even cashier's checks can be stop payment on. So there's all kinds of scams going on, and then people are gonna go to your house. Sometimes it's after dark, they wanna test drive your car. Forget about that. Just bring the car to Frontier Motors. 15 minutes, I can have you check and you're out of there. If you live in the community where it's not too far, we can give you a ride home. If you have a second set of keys, bring it in. If you got any service receipts, bring them in. That's how fast that can go. And other than if it's a complete piece of junk, we just about buy anything. You know, now, the guy with the Rolls Royce, I didn't buy his Rolls Royce, but I'm helping him sell it. So there's always an answer. And even if for whatever reason we don't buy the car, maybe I've got 10 of those cars on the lot already, we can definitely help you out by showing you how to sell it, what to sell it for, and where to advertise that vehicle, what to do to get the car ready. So we've gone through depreciation, we've gone through the news, we talked a little bit about the free appraisals that we do at Frontier Motors. Actually, I haven't talked about the free appraisal. And the reason you would want a free appraisal is, let's say you want to buy a brand new car. Remember in the first segment of the show, I said, don't buy a new car because you pay too much. But there are people, last year, 17.2 million people did not take my advice and decided to buy a brand new car. So why would they need Frontier Motors? Well, a couple reasons. I've got the new car cost guides available. These are the invoice books. Consumers Reports charges $12.95 for an invoice. We charge nothing. Now, the reason you want to know the invoice is because if you know what the dealer paid for the car, wouldn't that help you get a good deal? Sometimes you'll be surprised that the markup of the new car is not very much at all. I remember years ago when I got in the car business in 1975, a Chevy Impala was marked up 25%. I remember selling my first, actually it was a Caprice. It was $10,000 and the dealer cost was $7,500. So there's $2,500 worth of markup. Some of these cars have 4% markup, folks. You know, the days of the huge discount are over with, unless you're looking at a $70,000 pickup truck or rebates and incentives that make up the difference. But if you know the cost of the car, it helps you. The other thing is, why not get an opinion on what that dealer should be appraising your car for? Within minutes, I can tell you, here's the retail value. Here's what we'll write you a check for your car. Wouldn't that be nice to know? And shouldn't you be getting a little bit more from the dealer of your choice if you're going to buy a brand new car than what I give you if you're not buying a car from me? If I tell you I'll buy your car from you for $25,000 and you go to the new car dealership, let's say you go to Lexus and Mobile and you want to buy a brand new Lexus, they should be offering you more than that because you're spending $50,000 with them. If you're spending money with them, I think they should give you more. But you stop at Frontier Motors and get that opinion. Now, I brought one of my friends that we do business with, does a great testimonial for Frontier Motors. And he talks a little bit in 60 seconds about what it takes me half an hour to do on the show. So I should have actually played this first because I wouldn't have to talk anymore. But let's go ahead and listen to Dave.
Hey, Dave Ramsey here. When you need a quality pre-owned vehicle, I'm happy to be recommending a dealer that still does it the old-fashioned way, where relationship is formed from face-to-face contact, where a handshake still means something. For 22 years, my friends at Frontier Motors have been helping the Pensacola community with their transportation needs, but they do so much more. They are the go-to dealer for free advice, free appraisals, free Carfax reports, and free total loss and diminished value reports. Any car buying questions, see Frontier Motors. 70% of their customers are repeat or referrals. It's unheard of in the used car industry. I'm talking no pushy salesman, no pressure selling, always an out-the-door price in writing, and no mausoleum, high overhead showroom. Just 400 of the nicest used cars you'll ever see. Check out Frontier Motors, and don't forget to tell them Dave Ramsey sent you.
Yeah, that's pretty nice that Dave does an endorsement for us. And matter of fact, when Dave came to town, he does 1620 on AM radio. Actually, they're FM radio also now. And they came to us. The Ramsey Group came to us and said, we pick one Metro dealer. It's always a used car dealer. He does not recommend new car dealers because obviously he's the money guru. So he would tell you to buy used if you're going to buy, unless you're a multimillionaire. But he would he picked us out out of all the dealers in Pensacola. There's 102 used car dealers in Pensacola. And he knocked on our door and said, hey, we will do the spot for you. Obviously, we have to pay for the advertising. But I didn't solicit him. He solicited us. And he went to the Better Business Bureau. He went to Google Reviews. And he picked our dealership, which is kind of a feather in our cap. When we talk about what's going on in the industry, I love Consumers Reports. You know, I read it cover to cover, and every 6 months they have a car magazine that does only cars, and they just came up with the new how the brands stack up. I love reading this because it changes from year to year. And last year, I believe it was Genesis, and this year, it's Subaru. Whoop-de-doo for my Subaru. Remember the old commercial? I thought that was so cool. Whoop-de-doo for my Subaru. Subaru is number one. So people come to an independent dealer like Frontier Motors. The really cool thing about us is we don't have to push one product over another. If you want a car that's ranked at the bottom, and right now it's Fiat, by the way, we sell Fiats. We can sell you anything you want. But if you ask our opinion, obviously, the brand, how the brand stacks up is going to be very important to you. And by the way, that's not just reliability. They have a different one just for reliability. This is overall, which means reliability. It means roadability. It means safety, obviously crash tests, stopping power, turning radius, customer satisfaction. Would you buy that same car again? So they put this all in a group and they say they come out with the best average. Subaru is number one. Genesis, the Highline division of Hyundai, is number two, which, by the way, we sell a lot of Genesis products. Porsche, unbelievable. Porsche, 20 years ago, were junk, is number three. Not anymore. They're great cars. Matter of fact, we're buying a Boxster today with 2,000 miles on it, Porsche Boxster. Audi, happy to report. We got a new Audi dealership, been in business for about a year in Pensacola. So we have an Audi service department in Pensacola. That's number four. Lexus, number five. Mazda. People ask me about Mazda. Mazda is number six. Over BMW and over Lincoln, over Toyota. Lincoln's made a big comeback. They're at number eight. I love Lincolns. We got a brand new 2018 Navigator on the lot. Man, is that thing beautiful with 13,000 miles on. We've only got a minute left, so folks, I want to let you know that this is going to be on Facebook. So if you want to recommend our show, go to Facebook, put in Frontier Motors. We're going to be there. We also got, this will also be on YouTube. And you can, you can Google Frontier Motors. It'll pop up. So again, if you're looking for free advice, folks, we're not just a place to spend money. We're a place to help you when you're in the market, and it doesn't necessarily have to be from us. If you've found another dealership or a friend that's selling a car, come to us and we'll tell you what to pay, and we'll give you the straight scoop on the car. We'll do the free history report. We'll tell you if we think that's a good car or a bad car, or if there's other cars that I would recommend on top of that car. Maybe it's a bad year for whatever reason. Maybe it's a first year car that we wouldn't recommend, and we'll share that information with you, and we'll also tell you where we got that information, so it's not just us trying to kink your deal to get you to buy from us. We don't do that. We know we're not the only game in town, but we want to be the dealership that you recommend when you are in the market for a car. Also, go to frontiermotorsinc.com. We have between 350 and 400 cars on the lot, 31 detailed photographs that all have pricing on them. And thanks for listening. Thanks for watching. Have a great day. I'll be the same. Down the
street, got the best deals that can't be beat. Don't overpay, come in today. Doing business the old-fashioned way. Frontier, we've got the right price. Frontier, we'll treat you mighty nice. Frontier Motors, low overhead country.